students, the problem given here is obtain the Fourier series expansion of the periodic function f of x with the period 4 defined by f of x is equal to 1 plus x between the interval minus 2 is less than or equal to x, x is less than or equal to 0, and f of x is equal to 1 minus x between the interval 0 is less than or equal to x, x is less than or equal to 2, and hence deduce that sigma n is equal to infinity 1 divided by 2n minus 1 the whole squared, which is equal to pi by 8. So the function is defined between two intervals, minus 2 is less than x, is less than x, x is less than 0, 0 is less than x, x is less than 2. So it is of the model minus L comma L. So the first step is to write the Fourier series expansion of f of x in between the interval minus 2 comma 2. That is, the given function is of the model minus L comma L. For minus L comma L model, the Fourier series expansion f of x is written as a0 divided by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity an into cos n pi x divided by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x divided by 2. Now let you test the function, whether it is an even function or an odd function. Given that f of x is equal to phi 1 of x in the interval minus 2 comma 0 and phi 2 of x in the interval 0 comma 2, and phi 1 of x is equal to 1 plus x, phi 2 of x is equal to 1 minus x. Now let you create phi 1 of minus x. Phi 1 of minus x is equal to 1 minus x, which is equal to phi 2 of x. When phi 1 of minus x is equal to phi 2 of x, it is the function, given function is, given function f of x is an even function. For an even function, bn is equal to 0. This you have to remember, that for an even function, bn is equal to 0. Now, step number 2 is to find a0. Step number 2 is to find a0. A0 between the interval 2 comma minus 2 is defined, or it is equal to 1 by 2 integral of minus 2 to 2 f of x into dx. Now f of x has been defined between two intervals, so you have to substitute for f of x these two intervals. So it is 1 by 2 integral of minus 2 to 0 f of x into dx is the one interval, plus integral of 0 to 2 f of x into dx is the other interval. Now substitute for f of x, it is 1 by 2 integral of minus 2 to 0 1 plus x into dx plus integral of 0 to 2 1 minus x into dx. Now integrating the first term, it is x power in model, it is 1 plus x the whole square divided by 2. Now you substitute the limits between minus 2, 0. And the integration of the next term is 1 minus x the whole squared is, 1 minus x, the integration of the next term is 1 minus x, integration of 1 minus x. It is also of the model, x power n model, it is 1 minus x the whole squared divided by the differentiation of 1 minus x. 1 minus x the whole squared divided by 2, the differentiation of 1 minus x is, differentiation of 1 is 0, minus x is 1, so the denominator already there is a 2, minus 1 into 2 it will become minus 2. You substitute the limit between 0 to 2, it is equal to 1 by 2, substituting the upper limit in the first term, upper limit is 0, 1 plus 0 the whole square divided by 2, so it is 1 by 2, and similarly substituting the lower limit minus 2, 1 minus 2 the whole square, it is in the bracket plus 1 minus 2, it is become minus 1, so minus 1 the whole square is 1, so it is minus 1 by 2. And next you substitute the limit for the second term, for upper limit is 2, so 1 minus 2 the whole square divided by minus 2, so it is minus 1 by 2. And substituting the lower limit, minus of 1 minus 0 the whole square divided by minus 2, so it is plus 1 by 2. Now it is equal to 0, therefore we have found out that a0 is equal to 0. Now step number 3 is to find the value for an. We know that an is equal to between the limits minus 2 comma 2, it is 1 by 2, integral of minus 2 to 2 f of x into cos n pi x divided by 2 into dx. You know that f of x has been defined between two intervals, so we have to substitute f of x for those two intervals. Now an is equal to 1 by 2 integral of minus 2 to 0 f of x into cos n pi x divided by 2 into dx plus integral of 0 to 2 f of x into cos n pi x divided by 2 into dx. Now substitute the value of f of x. An is equal to 1 by 2 integral of minus 2 to 0. In the interval minus 2 to 0, f of x is 1 plus x. So 1 plus x into cos n pi x divided by 2 into dx plus 0 to 2, integral of 0 to 2. In the interval 0 to 2, f of x is equal to 1 minus x. So it is integral of 0 to 2, 1 minus x into cos n pi x divided by 2 into dx. Now there are two integrations are there, and both the terms are in the form of uv dx. Uv dx is Bernoulli's expansion. It is u into v1 minus u dash into v2 plus u double dash into v3 minus u triple dash into v4. Now let us use the Bernoulli's expansion for the first term. U is 1 plus x into v1 is the integral of v. V is cos n pi x divided by 2. Integration of cos is sine. So it is sine n pi x divided by 2 whole divided by the differentiation of n pi x. The differentiation of n pi x divided by 2 is n pi divided by 2. The next integration is minus of u dash into v2. U dash is the differentiation of 1 plus x. The differentiation of 1 plus x is 1, so it is minus 1. Now v2 is the integration of v1. V1 is sine n pi x divided by 2 whole divided by n pi by 2. Now the integration of sine is minus cos, so it is minus cos nx divided by 2 whole divided by the differentiation of n pi x divided by 2. The differentiation of n pi x divided by 2 is n pi by 2. Already there is an n pi by 2. So n pi by 2 into n pi by 2 is n squared pi squared divided by 4. Now you need to substitute the limits between minus 2 to 0. Now we shall go for the integration of the second term is between the limits 0 to 2. It is also uv dx model. So using Bernoulli's expansion, first u is 1 minus x here, so 1 minus x into integration of cos n pi x divided by 2, that is v1. Integration of cos is sine, so sine n pi x divided by 2 divided by the differentiation of n pi x divided by 2, it is n pi divided by 2, minus u dash is the differentiation of 1 minus x. The differentiation of 1 minus x is minus 1, so it is written here as, already as per formula there is a minus, and the differentiation of 1 minus x is minus 1, so into v2 is the integration of sine n pi x divided by 2 whole divided by n pi by 2. So integration of sine is minus cos, so it is minus cos n pi x divided by 2 whole divided by the differentiation of n pi x divided by 2. The differentiation of n pi x by divided by 2 is n pi by 2. Already there is an n pi by 2, so n pi by 2 into n pi by 2, it is n square pi square divided by 4. Now you have 0 to 2. Now we need to substitute the limits and look into the sin n pi x divided by 2 whole divided by n pi divided by 2 term. So when you are substituting, the upper limit 0, so sin n pi x will become sin 0, sin 0 is equal to 0. And when you substitute the lower limit minus 2 also, sin n pi x divided by 2 will become sin of minus n pi. So sin of minus n pi, it is minus sin of n pi. So sin n pi, again it is equal to 0. So by substituting the first limits minus 2 comma 0, sin term is becoming 0. Similarly, in the second term, in the second integral, sin nx n pi x divided by 2 is there. By substituting the upper limit, sin n pi x by 2 will become sin n pi. So sin n pi is equal to 0. Similarly, substituting the lower limit 0, sin n pi x divided by 2 will become sin 0. Sin 0 is also equal to 0. So the sin n pi x divided by 2 whole divided by n pi divided by 2 is becoming 0 when we substitute the limits minus 2 comma 0 and also the limits 0 comma 2. So we need not bother about sin term. Now let us substitute the limits for the cos term, and 1 by 2 into, first you substitute the upper limit 0 in cos n pi x divided by 2 whole divided by n square pi square divided by 4. So there are two minuses, minus 1 and minus cos, so it will become plus. Now substituting the upper limit 0, cos n pi x divided by 2 will become cos 0. Cos 0 is equal to 1, so it is written as 1 divided by n square pi square divided by 4. Now substituting the lower limit minus 2, it is becoming cos of, so minus sign is here for the, when we substitute the lower limit we will put a minus sign. So cos of n pi x divided by 2 will become cos of minus pi is cos n pi, because the angle is in the fourth quadrant. Cos so it is written as minus cos n pi divided by n square pi square divided by 4. And substituting the limits 0 comma 2, so there are three minuses, minus of minus 1 and minus cos. So it is minus, for minus term is there, so minus is taken here. When substituting the upper limit 2, cos n pi x divided by 2 will become cos n pi. So it is cos n pi divided by n squared pi squared divided by 4. And when you substitute, you will put a minus. There is already a minus. Minus of minus will become plus. And when 0 is substituted, cos n pi x divided by 2 will become cos 0. Cos 0 is 1, so it is 1 divided by n squared pi squared divided by 4. So it is equal to 1 by 2. Now you move the 4 in the denominator to the numerator. So it is becoming 4 divided by, the first term is 4 divided by n squared pi squared. The second term is minus 4 cos n pi divided by n squared pi squared. The third term is minus 4 cos n pi divided by n squared pi squared. The fourth term is 4 divided by n squared pi squared. Now, there are 2, 4 divided by n squared pi squared. So 2 into 4 divided by n squared pi squared, it is 8 n squared pi squared. Similarly, the other two terms are added, it is becoming 8 cos n pi divided by n squared pi squared. Now we can take 8 squared pi squared commonly outside. It is 8 divided by 2 into n squared pi squared into 1 minus cos of n pi. So which is equal to 4 divided by n squared pi squared into 1 minus cos of n pi, can be written as minus 1 to the whole power n. Now when n is even, so minus 1 power even will give you a plus number, plus 1. So it is equal to 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. So equal to 0 when n is even. And an is equal to 8 divided by n squared pi squared when n is odd. When n is odd, so the minus power will generate a minus 1, minus of minus 1 plus 1. So 2 into 4, it is becoming 8 divided by n squared pi squared when n is odd. We know that the step number 4 is, we have already checked that the function f of x is an, when the function f of x is even, bn, the Fourier coefficient bn is equal to 0. Now the final step is step number 5. It is to write Fourier series expansion for f of x. We know that a0 is equal to 0, an is equal to, n is equal to 1 comma 3 comma 5 to infinity, 8 divided by pi squared, n squared pi squared, and bn is equal to 0. Now f of x in between 2 comma minus 2 is written as f of x is equal to a0 divided by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi x divided by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x divided by 2. Here the term a0 is 0, bn is 0, therefore f of x is written as sigma n is equal to 1 comma 3 comma 5 to infinity 8 divided by pi squared n squared pi squared into cos n pi x divided by 2. Now we can change n is equal to r to infinity to n is equal to 1 to infinity. When n is equal to r to infinity is changed to n is equal to 1 to infinity, replace n by 2n minus 1. Now f of x can also be written as f of x is equal to n is equal to 1 to infinity, n is replaced by 2n minus 1, so it is 8 divided by 2n minus 1 the whole squared into pi squared into cos n pi x divided by 2. Now the final step is deduction. Now you look into the f of x function, it is having a point of discontinuity at x is equal to 0. Now put x is equal to 0 in the equation marked as a. When x is equal to 0, cos n pi x divided by 2 will become cos 0. So cos 0 is equal to 1. Therefore f of 0 can be written as n is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity 8 divided by 2n minus 1 the whole square into pi square. Also we can write f of 0 is equal to f of 0 minus 0 plus f of 0 plus 0. And f of 0 minus 0, putting x is equal to 0, it is 1. And f of 0 plus 0, putting x is equal to 0, it is also 1. So 1 plus 1 divided by 2 is equal to 1. Now, both the f of 0s can be equated. And this f of 0, and this f of 0 can be equated. And equating these two f of 0s, we can get sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity 8 divided by 2n minus 1 the whole squared into pi squared is equal to 1. And moving pi squared 8 by pi squared to the right hand side, the equation will become sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 divided by 2n minus 1 the whole squared is equal to pi squared by 8, which is the required deduction. This is the required deduction.